Taking care of the ball. Pacific Life game summary. Here's Deshaun Foster. Ball's loose. Tank Williams gets it. Boom. Turn it over. Give it to Allen. He takes it in for the touchdown. Stanford in control of the ball game. Corey Paws goes deep. Thinks he has a touchdown. Fernandez runs up Ryan Smith's back. He makes the interception. Another turnover. They pass underneath to Carter. He takes it to the house. This has been all Stanford. And of course, UCLA has not gotten any breaks. Now they're hanging their heads a little bit. Plenty of time in the ball game. They've got to change this thing mentally, get into the ball game.
Now let's see. They've got 2, 5, 7, 8, 9 in the box. Soft, lofted pass downfield. Intercepted by Mike Ware. Matt Ware just standing there. The ball was thrown right to him, and he's tackled up the line of scrimmage, the 20-yard line.
Big turnover. Big turnover. It can get UCLA back into the ball game if they can get a touchdown of this with just under 3 to play in this half. That's a bad choice by Lewis because they had him covered. Watch. Here's Ware right here. Now watch this. Here's your coverage. Pretty good coverage. Now you bring the safety over. You've got two guys there. Bad pass, underthrown, bad decision, shouldn't have gone there in the first place. They get the big return, takes it all the way back to the 19, and UCLA now has a chance to get back in this thing.
Ball just inside the 20. It'll be first down at the 19 officially. Deshaun Foster gets the pitch, going to the right side, feet slide out from under him, and down he goes at the 21. He saw a man coming, knew he couldn't get away from him by continuing to go to the right, tried to stop, couldn't.
But look at Deshaun, just walking around almost in a daze. He's got 7 carries, 28 yards. He's thinking, what else can go wrong? My cleats aren't holding. I'm not getting any open space. They're in my face as soon as I touch it. I fumbled once.
Ball's closer to the 22-yard line. Second down, call it 12.
A lot of football yet to be played.
Balls to throw. Wanted to go to the end zone. Got away from one man. Another one's chasing him down. And finally, he does throw it incomplete. He got away from Matt Friedrichs. Otherwise, he'd had a big loss. Carter defending on the pass.
This play was doomed from the get-go. The play action wasn't very good. And Stanford got good penetration. Look at this. They're just fighting through. Here comes Fredericks, and he did miss a tackle. He should have had him in the backfield, but it's a smart play by Corey to throw it away and get rid of it. Once you're outside the tackle, you can throw it away, and that's the toughest thing to teach a quarterback. Some of your best passes are incompletions.
Third down and 13 now for UCLA. Timeout. Bruins call it. They need something here, though. They really need something out of this possession after that interception. Third and 13. Balls with plenty of time and now runs out of time. Knocked down all the way back on the 33-yard line by Lewis Hobson. Here's another Canadian youngster from Toronto, Lewis Hobson.
Well, you look at these guys coming. You look here. Here's Wire. Wire's coming. He also got a piece of them. They outnumber them. They come hard off the corner. They can't stop them all. And Paws runs out of time. Hobson, number 90, gets there. Coy Wire came hard from the middle position, his middle linebacker spot. UCLA's going for it in fourth and forever.
Fourth and 20. High snap, but Paws handled it. He's got a lot of green grass in front of him, but he wants to go to the end zone with it. Can't get it to the end zone, and the pass is incomplete. Ryan Smith defended by Ryan Fernandez. So the two Ryans have been having quite a battle, and so far, it's advantage Fernandez.
This is a terrific play by Paws, though. Better play by the defense, but Paws bought all the time he could. He saw the open ground and knew that he could run, but he couldn't get to the first down, so he's waiting for Ryan Smith, 83, to clear. He's waiting. He's waiting. Fernandez, 7, has good coverage. He's waiting. He's still in trouble. Now, instead of moving to the open area, then finally Ryan comes back and tries to make the reception, but he's got to work with him, skate to that far side while Paws is scrambling.
And so Stanford holds and takes over at their own 30-yard line with 1:16 to play in the first half. Well, the UCLA Bruins can't get anything out of the Ware interception. And Stanford now probably will be happy to run the clock out and go to the clubhouse. Coming up, the Capital One halftime show. John Saunders and Terry Bowden have plenty to talk about from what's already happened and what is happening and what may happen in this day of college football. Second down and seven. You think Lewis will uncork one? I doubt it. What do you mind? Here's Kerry Carter. Half a minute to go in the first half.
Guarantee you when they get in the clubhouse, Bob Toledo is going to be telling them the second half is theirs. UCLA Bruins have outscored opponents 72-0 in the third quarter this season. They might need all of those in this one.
Jason Stevens has just hobbled off the field for UCLA. And Ben Emanuel is in. And the clock is ticking, and it's halftime. At halftime, the startling score, Stanford 28 and UCLA 7. Enough to send your hairline up and down like window shades. Stanford 28, UCLA 7, and the Pac-10 standings as we started play today going to change, it looks like, and change dramatically. Washington State and Oregon will play right after we finish here on ABC Sports. And right now, here is some more startling news from Todd Harris.
Well, Keith, a bit of a surprise. Corey Paz, unfortunately, has hurt his hand, his throwing hand. He threw the ball, hand came down on top of a helmet. He is done probably for the rest of the day. They said they'll keep an eye on it. If they have to bring him back, they will. But right now, it will be McEwen for the UCLA Bruins at quarterback.
Scott McEwen, a senior from Thousand Oaks, California, 6'3", 199, will come in as the quarterback for the Bruins here in the second half of play. So UCLA is up again. It.
No question about that, partner. And it's a steep hill, 28-7.
Their undefeated season and their number three ranking in the BCS standings on the line. Not to mention the conference championship. And here's the kickoff by Stanford, starting the second half of play at the 1 yard line. It's Craig Bragg. And Bragg goes down hard, short of the 20.
You know, it wasn't just Corey Paws who was struggling, and he was only 5 of 16. But it was Deshaun Foster who came into the game averaging 155 yards. Linebackers, 52, 22, they're all over him. The defensive line, Lee and Piper and Freeman and Hoover dominating UCLA. And Foster could never get off, could never get on track. He ended the first half with 8 carries and only 26 yards, including this fumble, which gave the ball back to Stanford. So it's not just Paws, it's not just Foster, it's the offensive line. UCLA never got in sync.
353 total yards for Stanford.
Look at the bottom, Keith. Time of possession 21-25 for Stanford. And what that does, that keeps Stanford's defense on the sidelines. They give up 31 points a game, but the offense was on the field the whole time, kept the defense off. UCLA never really got a chance to score on them that much.
The thing that really is further eye-opening is how they control Deshaun Foster is exemplified in the rushing statistics there. 158 yards for the Cardinal to only 19 for UCLA. So here's UCLA now with the football. First down at their own 18-yard line, 28-7. Stanford is leading. Corey Paws, the quarterback, is out of the lineup with a battered hand. Thumb hit a helmet. That was Deshaun Foster carrying the ball with Scott McEwen in there at quarterback now for UCLA.
Yeah, and the thing is that Stanford just found out that Paws wasn't in the ball game, and the Stanford coaches are now starting to adjust to this. They're saying, wait a minute, Paws is out. They didn't know he was hurt, and all of a sudden they see McEwen come in, and now they will adjust a little bit.
It's second down and 8. The ball is at the 20-yard line. Ewan back, gets the ball in the air. Pass is caught. Thrown to Tab Perry.
More importantly, they've kept their own defense on the sidelines by eating up the time of possession.
And the UCLA touchdown was scored by the defense, not the offense. Ball is handed to Foster. He found some room. Hanging on to him as he goes up to the 40-yard line and 41-yard line is Coy Wire. Foster's biggest gain of the day, 9 yards. Second down and one. McEwen changing the play at the line of scrimmage. Back to Foster. Takes a hard hit from Fernandez coming up from the corner spot, but he's got the first down at the 44-yard line. Deeply so. McEwen's pass thrown to the outside to Ryan Smith. Smith with some blocking help over there is going to come out of it with about 5 yards before Tank Williams comes thundering through to make the play.
He just came flying over there. He stopped what looked like was a sure first down.
Came here from Bay St. Louis, Mississippi. Only two schools offered him a scholarship coming out of high school, Central Florida and UCLA. McEwen's pass intercepted by Lewis Hobson. Second big play of the day for the big tackle. Anthony Gabriel was in the face of McEwen and forced more air under the ball perhaps than he wanted, and Hobson intercepted.
Well, you've got that right. That whole play was Gabriel. They brought the linebacker. They put him over here. They're bringing him hard down here to get in the face of the quarterback. It goes the opposite way, and watch. Here comes 52, Gabriel. He just throws off balance, ill-advised, throwing back across his body. This is a poorly thrown pass and a bad decision. His feet are never set. He sees the pressure. He's just trying to unload it, and he gives it back to Stanford.
On the UCLA 40, first down for the Cardinal. Give it to Brian Allen. And Brian Allen slashes for 3 yards. He played at Iowa. Second down and seven. Lewis's pass is well thrown and caught by Casey Moore out of the backfield. So Casey's back. You got a penalty flag thrown back in the quarterback area.
This might be a frustration foul against UCLA hitting the quarterback late.
Yeah, roughing the passer. That's another Bruin mistake. Stanford over the years, Stanford leads the conference in the fewest penalties. The Bruins were there for a while, but now they're making some mistakes.
They picked up Thomas. There's your play action, and the pass was thrown perfectly. And then Ben Emanuel, the young freshman, comes off the corner and hits him late. Ben Emanuel in the ballgame for Jason Stevens. Here he comes, 24. He hadn't been in the ballgame very much, and he gets called for a stupid penalty there.
And it's first down at the 15-yard line of UCLA. 28-7, Stanford leads, and then knocking on the door again. Brian Allen coming to the outside. Can't get much, and another penalty flag goes down.
Offense, 10 yards, previous spot, still first down.
That is Stanford's first penalty in the game today.
Boy, Stanford has scored every conceivable way. Here's the pass to Luke Powell, 20 yards, touchdown. That's one wide receiver. Then you go to your tight end, Teo Johnson, spectacular one-hand grab. Bring in Brian Allen, the running back, 35 yards. See ya. And then here comes Carter, 26-yard touchdown. Let him get in the game as well. They have scored every conceivable way against the Pac-10's best defense.
Penalty puts the ball back at the 25-yard line. It's first down and 20. Chris Lewis to throw it. Throws underneath. Goes to Carter out of the backfield. And the big back, 235-pounder, pounds his way down to the 13. Chris Lewis 0 for 3 as a starter, trying to snap that string. And the other thing about the pop is nobody scored on UCLA in the third quarter all season. And Kerry Carter diving will get very little out of it. Robert Thomas was right there, and they're going to be looking at third down and quite long. Ball's on the 13-yard line, third down and 8. That's Luke Powell coming in motion. Lewis throws, incomplete. Diving is Ricky Manning. 30-yard field goal try. Plenty of leg on Baselli. If everything goes as planned,
he's 2 for 3 from this range.
Snap's
this year.
Good. The kick is up, and the kick is good. And it goes to 31-7, Stanford leading UCLA at 9:44 to go in the third quarter. And Phil Snow wondering what's happening. Every Saturday during the season, there's the possibility of what we've had today, but there was always one Saturday where the sky falls.
And this is that Saturday. I mean, the sky has fallen all day, and then we come to this ball game, and I don't think anybody expected this. Stanford's domination, although we got a clue yesterday talking with the coaches, the Stanford coaches were so confident
We got a clue last week up at Eugene, Oregon.
Yeah, isn't that the truth?
When they came back from 42-28. And going into the final quarter, and a very good football team couldn't hold it.
Now Scott McEwen gets another shot here as he comes back at quarterback, and he's 8-for-11 for the year with one interception, no touchdowns.
And the first point scored against UCLA in the third quarter, put up there on the field goal by Michelle. Maryland is one of the six undefeated teams in the country. Back to McEwen on second down. Time to throw. Throws underneath. Pass incomplete. Looked like Tab Perry was the man, but there were Cardinals everywhere you looked. He was in deep traffic. It is third and 10. Ball is well thrown. Caught by Craig Bragg. And Bragg with a big play all the way to the Stanford 46-yard line before they finally corral him. First down at the Stanford 46. McEwen back going deep. A lot of air under the ball. Incomplete. Tab Perry covered by Reuben Carter. Carter is 5'8", Tab Perry 6'3".
And I want to tell you something. You cannot get better coverage than you just had from Reuben Carter. You talk about a mismatch. He's only 5'8". Here he is at the top of your screen. Tab closes in on him. Now thinks he can run by him. But look, he's playing him inside out. Knows where the sideline is. The ball's underthrown. Almost had the interception. That's because of his position. That's why that play was defended so well. Just kind of squashed him between the sideline and himself and had great, great body position.
Foster, the single back for the Bruins. Stanford defense jumping around. Looked like they're not quite sure what they want to do. McEwen steps back and lets it go over the head of the intended receiver, Ryan Smith. You know what, Tim? Reuben Carter at 5'8", as a senior, you know he's had a lot of footballs thrown at him over the years.
Well, and I'll tell you something else.
How.
He's 5'8", 177, you're right, and he's the third leading tackler on the team. Yeah. He's active, he's tough. Yep. Here comes another big third down situation for UCLA. But if they don't get this, they'll go for it on fourth.
Third and 10. 31-3. Stanford leading in the third quarter. 31-7. McEwen's pass is well thrown. Grab complete. Mike Seidman, the tight end, gets this catch. Fourth and 2. They go to Foster.
Quick slant.
Nope, he's going in motion.
Quick slant. There it is.
Worked. Pass is thrown hard. Craig Bragg makes the catch, and he's got a first down at the 35-yard line. Foster goes outside. And McEwen throwing. Wants to throw it to him. Instead, it's batted down by big old Austin Lee. 6'6", 275-pound tackle from Post Falls, Idaho.
This is a tough defense that really has been tough against the run all year. And now you look at 94, he's 6'6", 275, and Lee reaches up and blocks the pass. That is hard to throw over if he's blocked into the passing lane.
Second down and 10.
Here's your most dangerous receiver right there, the slot man inside. Tab Perry.
Looking for him, throws for Perry, and it's incomplete. Hank Williams was involved. Hank was going after the quarterback on a full bore blitz.
And they're making it tough on him every single time. Here's your slot. Here's Tab Perry here against the slant. He's open. Boom. Misses the ball, and the contact comes immediately.
And Reuben Carter again.
And Carter has played well. You see Coy Wire is coming hard. They pick him up. But that ball should have been caught because 42, Reuben Carter really didn't knock it loose. He went over Tab Perry.
Third and 10. To the sideline. Ball caught by Perry. Short of the first down. Foster. Got it. Breaks it. Inside the 20, down inside the 15-yard line. Fernandez finally brought him down. It's first down, UCLA. Ball is just inside the 15-yard line. Foster. That looks more like Foster. He's down to the 5, a yard short of a first down. Here's second down and 1. Go to Foster. He's got the first down. It'll be first and goal. UCLA on about the Stanford 3. It's a lot of hard hitting going on. Foster dives short. Gained about a yard. Odari was up on top of the stack along with Gabriel and Wire and others.
Boy, nothing fancy there, it's just zone blocking, but I want you to watch 13. Here's your ball carrier. Here comes the collision. X marks the spot. Roll it, and you'll see Tank Williams, 13, reading it, sliding, boom! Head to head, hat to hat, knocked him down on the 1.
Second down and goal. Ball at the 2. Foster again. There's the hole. And there is your touchdown. UCLA's first touchdown of the day.
This has been a tough front to run against, giving up only less than 100 yards a game. But I want you to watch Foster and why they think he's a great running back, why the pros are drooling to get him. Great cut, step over the lineman, now power it in against 2, 3, 4 red jerseys, and he makes it into the end zone.
Chris Griffith for the point. It's good. 4 minutes and 6 seconds remain to play in the third quarter. Bruins get their first touchdown of the day, and Stanford is ahead by 17 at 31-14. Bruins still alive. Deshaun Foster finally finds the end zone for UCLA, and they're sort of back in the ball game at 31-14. And 4:06 to go in the third quarter. Now the burden of proof shifts over to the defensive side of the ball, as now Stanford has a little bit of proving to itself to see whether or not they can eat up some clock. Pixie's kick is a knuckleball that goes into the end zone. And it'll come back to the 20. Here's Todd Harris.
Well, Keith, just want to update you on Blaine Kazarian. They want to make sure that nothing serious has happened. He checked out, as Timmy pointed out, all extremities were moving. They feel right now it's probably a severe concussion. But they've got great medical facilities here, and they're going to check him out.
Thank you.
There's his dad trying to get everybody back into this ball game emotionally. UCLA scored, but you have the feeling that the defense still hadn't figured out this Stanford offense. They've got to make a stop here, and UCLA, I think, has to score before the end of this quarter to really consider themselves back in the ball game.
Ball is on the 20 for Stanford. First down, and the Bruin fans are down at that end of the field. Quite a few of them. Lewis's pass put high and deep and incomplete. He was trying to find Powell. He had a play action going with Carter, but the Bruins playing center field gave him no chance to complete it, and in particular, Matt Ware, who has an interception already today.
Boy, and remember who's minding center field. Matt Ware's on the corner and doing a nice job, but Jason Stevens, the fourth leading tackler, the senior safety, is now out of the ball game, and the freshman, Ben Emanuel, is minding center field. They went right after him.
Second down and 10. This is Carter. Bruins stuck him up on the 21. Third and long coming up.
Robert Thomas still playing his heart out. Very, very gutsy guy. Here's Thomas right here. Watch how he reacts and reads. And his read is in this triangle right here. He sees it's zone blocking. It's a run play. And he immediately runs to the ball like a cobra, coils and strikes. Great play by the linebacker.
Third down, 8. Lewis dumps it off to Bailey Johnson, and he's called a fumble, and the Bruins recover it. Ben Emanuel gets on it. That could have been an incomplete pass. Thomas was the man that separated the ball from Theo Johnson.
The official's still conferring.
Yep.
Talk about whether, in fact, he had control of the ball. Did he have possession?
That's close.
The pass has been ruled incomplete.
There you go.
I will tell you this. UCLA has not gotten a break all day. Take another look at it. You make the call. Here's the big guy. Here's the guy that gets the fumble. Pop it over the middle. Here he comes. You know what? He took a full step. That was a catch. He's got the football.
No, no. When he came down to
bobbling it. Came down bobbling it.
Yep, ball was loose. It was going through his hands. So it's fourth down. That was close.
Yeah, it was.
But they made, I think, the right call. Doesn't matter. They made the call.
Yeah, absolutely. And UCLA's going to get good field position.
Ball is fielded at the 44-yard line. Greg Bragg looking for daylight, didn't going to find any. Ricky Manning looking for the daylight, and they just rolled him back. All right, here they are, though, with still a good field position and 2:55 to go in the third quarter. Give the ball to Foster. Foster bounces off the first contact and gets 3 yards. Austin Lee finally put him down. And I guess the ball did come out because they're indicating a UCLA Bruin is on it, and it was Foster covering it.
Syracuse with a huge win today over Virginia Tech.
Georgia's giving Florida all they want in the third quarter.
Mark Rick doing a great job down with the Bulldogs. How about them Dogs?
Yeah, they'll be. Look at that. Michigan finally catches up with Iowa 20-20. That's a pretty good coaching job being done in Iowa City. Back goes McEwen. Ball thrown quickly to Smith. Smith is loose. And down inside the 25-yard line by Reuben Carter.
Can't talk enough about Ryan Smith and how much he's meant to this ball club. He was the most improved player from spring to fall. He steps in when Brian Poling-Dixon gets hurt. And he has just been spectacular. It's just a three-step drop, hit him quickly on the hitch, and let him run. And he splits the safeties and moves the chains down inside the 25. Nicely done by the young Ryan Smith.
32 yards on the play. Minute 52 to go in the third quarter. Almost wearing white right now. Back to Foster. Little slide. And then Tank Williams gets a hold of it. And the play stops.
I'll tell you this, if UCLA scores in the next minute and a half before this period ends, they are in this thing and you're
Tank's hurt.
You're not kidding, the momentum has changed.
Williams got up very slowly. So Deshaun Foster with that play crosses the 1,000-yard mark for the season. As the quickest anybody in UCLA history has ever reached the 1,000-yard mark.
He's worked for every inch of it today. 19 carries and 71 yards.
Second down, call it. Well, it's about eight, actually. And going down the middle, got him in. Touchdown, Mike Seitman.
Boy, Tank Williams bit on it.
Jason White.
White bit on it, and I'm telling you something. Mike Seitman just ran right by him. A couple big plays by Ryan Smith and Mike Seitman, roommates on that drive, made it work.
Good kick. Ball going into the end zone, 2 yards deep, and coming out with it's Brian Allen. And Allen will come across the 20 to the 22, and again, John in New York. Times Square Stadium.
Gave Michigan against Iowa. This may be as good a catch as we've seen this year. John Navarre looking for Marquise Walker. Goes up, craps the ball, taps it to himself for the touchdown, and Michigan takes the lead at 21-20. Meantime, Maryland has just scored, so once again, they are tied at Florida State at 31 apiece. Keith.
Pretty good stuff. 23-yard line now for Stanford, their own. They lead 31-21 with 40 seconds to go in the third quarter. Run it in the middle. with Brian Allen, and he'll get close to the 25. That's a 2-yard pickup.
I'll say this about that Maryland game. Ralph Friedgen, the new head coach, when he was offensive coordinator at Georgia Tech, used to give Florida State fits, averaged 30 points against Florida State.